This is a moment. This is a moment.
Good morning, everybody. You see, the first thing you need to do is to read your audience this morning, so I can see happy faces, I can see sad faces, I can see people that is going through some stuff. I see tears in some of your eyes. I have good news for you this morning, is that the Lord will take you all the way. Amen? Yes, let's just give Him a praise, man. Come on, He will take you all the way. Did you know that feelings come, emotions come, but they can never come first? Doesn't matter how I feel today. That's not the priority. There needs to be a governing authority over my emotions and over how I feel and over my circumstances. There needs to be something that I'm anchored in. There needs to be something that guides my life. And it's not my emotions or feelings. Isn't that, Tannie Joey? Ek meen Tannie het nou jare se ervaring. So in Tannie se opinie, waarin moet ons geanker wees vir ons om 'n goeie lewe te hê? Amen. Amen. Ek gaan leer by daai Tannie. So you get two types of churches. So I like our type of church. Okay, so you get the churches where everybody is doing the right thing and you can learn from them. But then you get churches like ours, where we have a collective knowledge of how not to live life and plenty of wrong choices. But you can also learn from us how not to do life. So at least we can make new mistakes, just as long as we learn from our mistakes. Amen? Amen. I need you to touch the person next to you and look them in the eyes and say, God will never leave you nor forsake you. Amen? Did you know that many of the people that is going through the same stuff as you and me this morning didn't wake up with us this morning? There is plenty of people coming from our background that went or that closed their eyes last night, but they didn't wake up this morning. That makes us fortunate. That makes us blessed, eh, Candace? That makes us blessed. Because our hope is anchored in what's to come. But there's stuff that we need to know, and there's stuff that we need to believe. So there's a difference between knowing and believing. I had a chat with somebody this morning about this difference between knowing and believing. There is something that you need to believe inside of your heart. That the love that God has for you is unconditional. And you cannot be separated from that love. No matter how you feel, no matter what you go through, God will take you all the way. But the question this morning is are you as committed as He is towards you? You also need to be committed to you. You also need to be committed to the process that you are in once you've given your heart and your life to the Lord. You need to be committed to that process. Solomon said it in Ecclesiastes, that the end of a thing is better than its beginning. You need to finish. You need to let Him take control over your life. He needs to have the final say. Amen? Amen. You can turn your Bibles to Romans 8. Today we're going to read Bible. Can we have people that can hand out the communion this morning? Please. Waar is ons seniors? Broer Nico van Rensburg en broer Bernard Olkers, die diakens van die NG gemeente Ryten. Romeine 8, just some background on the book of Romans. Dank julle. Vir die van julle wat nie weet hoe hierdie koppietjies werk nie, steek net julle hande op Die mense wat lank hierso is, sal vir julle kom verduidelik, so dit is 'n twee stap proses. So jy eers keer eers die boonste enetjie oop, dan die onderste enetjie oop. Maar vir die van julle wat geharde keier mense was, julle sal weet hoe dit werk. So jy moet hom nie afgooi en op jou kop sit, of iets is dit nie, jy moet hom nie double tap as jy hom neersit nie. Sheldon, dis nie waar ons is nie. Good to do communion. Good to remember what the Lord has done. Dit is goed. Die Bybel sê ons moet dit so gereeld as moontlik doen. This is something that you need to carry throughout your journey as a believer. When you walk through this open door, once you've given your heart to the Lord, is to keep Christ in mind always. What he has done and what he means to you. Nothing can separate you from this love that he has for you. Nothing. Is ons al daar so? Kyk hoe mooi is daai. So die skrif vanmôre kom uit Romeine 8 vers 35. Wat sê, who can separate us from the love of Christ? Paul wasn't looking for an answer back, as if there's a person or I'm somebody or an authority or a circumstance or something that can separate you. This is something that you need to fix in your heart. This is something that you need to believe, not only know, but believe. That there's nothing that can separate you from the love of Christ. There is so much confidence in that statement. There's nothing that can separate me. No matter how I feel, no matter what happens to me. Once you've given your heart to the Lord, you need to die to yourself. And you need to be made alive in this new person, this new creature. That is alive for one purpose. I'm not allowed to be alive for myself only. I'm alive to Him. Good news is that you only die once and we will live forever. Biggest lie that we've been told so far in our lives is that you only live once. You don't only live once. You only die once. Make sure that you are on the right side of this thing. Don't be one foot in the world and one foot in the kingdom of God. That's not how it operates. That's not how it's supposed to be done. That's not where you want to stand when Jesus comes again. And he will come again. Amen? Okay, so let's read. We're going to pick it up from verse 31. Romans 8, 31. Father, we just ask that you bless the seed, Lord. Your word is holy and forever settled in heaven. Nobody can add to it. Nobody can change it. Not the enemy. Not the rulers or the powers of this age. Thank you that we can believe in your word. Thank you that we can anchor our future and how we think and how we believe in what your word says. This is the governing authority over our lives and our emotions and our feelings. This is where we get the principle how we live by. Help us not to be led astray due to our own sensuality, due to our own ways of thinking, due to the strongholds in our life. But set us free, Lord. Open up the scripture this morning in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. We're going to read from verse 31 to let's see where we finish and where we go with this thing. So the title of the sermon this morning is Inseparable Love. I got two cups, so I'm definitely going to heaven. So. Wie is die grootste sondaar hierso binne? Asseblief steek op jou hand, kan ons net twee koppies vir die hand sou kry, asseblief. Nadine. the biggest mistake or the biggest pitfall that people make when they enter into this process, when you come here for the first time, when you reach out and put up your hands and say, I need help, the biggest mistake that people make is they depend on their feelings, their emotions, their way of thinking, which is contrary to the Word of God. In Proverbs 3, it says, don't lean on your own understanding of how things work or supposed to work, but acknowledge Him and trust Him in all of your ways. Amen? You can never make a life decision alone again. Did you know? Jy kan nie meer self besluit wat gebeur met jou lewe nie. Jy moet ophou besluit wat gebeur met jou lewe. Julle geweet. Nou moet ons die Here involve. En God is nie confused nie. God is not confused. Neither is He mocked. What you sow, you will reap. So as jy wil dinge in jou eie krag en jou eie mag doen en hoe jy dinge wil doen, dan gaan jy kry wat jy kan doen. And let's be honest, if we do things in our own power and we just have a look at our history, dan is dit net veiliger net om te sê, Here, waar's my lewe? Ek weet nie wat ek doen nie. I don't know what I'm doing. Help me. Please help me. Lord, help me. My life decisions and my life and my future belongs to You. The Bible says that He knows the plans that He has for us. We may have certain plans for our life, but did you know that your plans maybe worked for 5 minutes and it was glorious for 5 minutes? Until it wasn't. It's time that we relinquish control and we allow the people that God has placed over you in your life in this season to help you, to guide you, to teach you, to mentor you, to counsel you, to encourage you, to uplift you, to rebuke you, to correct you. All of us has been brought low in this season, brought low in life, so that we can learn who He is and learn who we are. Amen? Let's read. Hier ben julle kan volg, vers 31, Romeine 8. So we're going to read it twice this morning because there's stuff that we need to get from this morning. What then shall we say to these things? If God is for us, who can be against us? He who did not spare His own Son, but gave Him up for us all, how will He not also with Him graciously give us all things? 33. Who shall bring any charge against God's elect? Is it God who justifies? It is God who justifies. Who is to condemn? Christ Jesus is the one who died, but more than that, who was raised, who is at the right hand of God, who indeed is interceding for us. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation, shall distress, shall persecution, or famine, or nakedness, or danger, or sword? And is it, as it is written, for your sake we are being killed all day long. We are regarded as sheep to be slaughtered. No, in all these things we are more than conquerors through Him who loved us. For I am sure, neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor rulers, nor things present, or things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in creation will be able to separate us from the love of Christ Jesus, our Lord. Amen. Holy Spirit, I just ask that You protect the seed. Did you know that the most important part of your growth is the part that you cannot see? if we have a look at a tree or a plant or something, and even your own life, you grow in two directions. Not only upwards, you grow down as well. Did you know? Look at that tree outside. The most important part of its growth is the part that you cannot see. Below the surface. That's its anchor. That's its nourishment. That's the vital part. That's what will keep it upright during difficult seasons, during difficult times, when I want to make my own decisions. When tribulation comes, when distress comes, is how the other side of my growth looks. So it's good to have this awesome display up on the superficial part, and it looks like you are this glorious tree with this beautiful fruit. I want to focus this morning on the subsurface, the space that you cannot see, the intimacy, your believer, not your knower. I want to talk this morning about the condition of your heart. What you believe. Because what you believe is what you will be. That's what the Bible says. As a man thinketh in his own heart, so is he. Amen? So let's talk about what we believe. So if we believe that nothing can separate us from the love of Christ. If we believe that. So it's good to know that. It's good to understand from an intellectual point of view that nothing can separate you. Never did. But to believe it means that I'm unmovable. It means that there's something governing me. Everywhere I go, it governs my relationship. It governs my response in circumstances. It governs the way that I feel today. It governs my relationships with people that make it difficult for me to exist. Now, listen. The subsurface growth of your being, the spiritual part of you, your faith part, I would like to say that it's more important than the superficial part, the part that people can see. Your relationship with God and your relationship with people, how you feel deep inside of you, what you think. Turn your Bibles to Colossians 2. Say amen when you are there. Colossense. Samuel, jy moet nou nie inzoom nie. Ons is so geblessed in hierdie seisoen. Ek meen, look at the landscape of people that we have here. We have people that almost died, that is sitting amongst us. We have people from the suburbs that is sitting here. We have people from the streets that is sitting here. We have people that can work with their hands sitting here. We have businessmen sitting here. We have famous artists sitting here. Why are you laughing at me? Huh? Ons eers God is amazing. He has blessed us in this season. I was checking out the braai yesterday, and I was telling Jean, who's picking up the bill for the chicken that we braaied? Nobody invoiced us for this chicken that we braaied yesterday. Did you know? Somebody's picking up the bills. Each month when I'm doing the books, I'm realizing the same thing over and over again. Is that nothing makes sense. How we operate doesn't make sense. Dit is andersom. So ons help altyd eers die persoon. So dit is verskriklik impulsief. Pastor Matthys is, as jy hom ken vir 'n periode van tyd, is baie impulsief. Hy wil almal help. Partykeer ten koste van homself en sy eie tyd. Maar die hele leierskap is so, Derek is so, Tila is so, ons almal is so, dis en dis lekker om so te wees, want ons is die, we are the next chapter, en dis lekker om, dit is lekker om te sien, so ons gaan altyd ja sê vir die mama wat hulp nodig het, ons gaan ja sê vir die persoon wat vir die tweede of die derde of die vierde of die vijfde keer, Marie, hoeveelste keer is hierdie? Ons bly ja sê, ons gaan haal om, mense is kwaad vir ons, vraag vir ons, hoekom gaan haal jy hom weer? Why are you go fetching him? He doesn't want to change. It's because we believe. I believe in you. We will always be that people. And I need you to have the same heart's condition. Because there's something, Robin, that I need you to understand. Is that life is bigger than you. It's bigger than me. Amen? If we give up on each other, and the Bible says that nothing can separate us from the love of God, and that we need to be imitators of God on earth, that means that He will never disjoin Himself from you. You are joined to the hip with Christ. Inseparable love. That means that I have an inseparable love to Mario, irrelevant of his actions and how he does things. So if he chooses to step out of relationship, that doesn't mean that I'm going to stop believing that there will come a day and a time that he will be okay. I know that he's going to heaven. Jy het jou hart vir die Here gegee, né? Okay, great. Nou moet jy jou lewe vir hom gee. You owe him your life. Tatu. We owe him our life. No longer I that live. Stop, die. The best thing that you can do for yourself is to die to yourself. Let's read. Sorry, I'm getting sidetracked here. Ons gaan nou preek. En ek weet nie hoe om te preek nie. Ek was nie in Bybelskool nie. Ek het nie pampiere vir die ding nie. I don't have papers, but I know one thing. I know this guy that came and fetched me from a very deep pit. And it's somebody that I cannot see, but I know he exists. I've never audibly heard him, but I can hear him through you. I see the way that he handles us and walks with us and journeys with us and how he restores us. Kyk mooi hoe Sandra lyk oor 3 maande van nou af. En sê vir my die Here bestaan nie. En sê vir my die Here. Kyk mooi. Kyk mooi. Kyk mooi wat gebeur met dien se lewe van hier vorentoe. Kyk mooi Tatu. So Tatu kom in en hy weeg 47. Daai ou was gebou soos 'n briek toe hy hier so uit is. And each time God is willing to help us and to be with us. And he never left us, nor forsake. It is us that separates or think that we can separate ourselves. My apologies, my English is almost over. I have 10 minutes left of English. So I'm okay, so let's pick it up. Colossians 2 from verse 6. Is everybody there? I need your eyes to see what is written here. So we are talking about the subsurface growth and this inseparable love. Colossians 2 verse 6. This is good news for you. Unless if you're not concerned about good news today. The first question that you need to answer yourself is, are you allowed to receive the healing in the season? Because God will take you all the way. Don't give up a quarter of the way, a third of the way, halfway. Don't give up. Go all the way. Verse 6, therefore, as you receive Christ Jesus the Lord, He's the governor. As you receive Christ Jesus the Lord, so walk in Him. Let your conduct be worthy of this new person that is alive. You are dead, He's alive. So walk in Him, rooted and built up and established in the faith, just as you were taught. Today you are being taught. Moenie môre sê jy het nie geweet nie. Being rooted, built up and established in the faith that he is governing your life. Relinquish control, surrender, submit. Abounding in thanksgiving. We must be in a thankful posture. Not thankful of to be in ark. Yes, we must be grateful for this season, but they must be thanksgiving must be abounding in your heart. You needed a savior and he was there. You needed somebody that can save you. Sheldon, you're almost asleep. Well done. Yeah. Breathe, brother. Okay. Sunday mornings are an active time for the enemy to come and snatch seed from your ears. Because faith comes by hearing, and hearing from the Word of God. So if we read from the Bible and you are falling asleep, guess who's trying to snatch the seed? You see that there is a difference between knowing and believing. So the difference between knowing and believing lies in the depth of conviction and how these concepts of knowing and believing impacts our behavior and our emotions and the way that we see things and the perspective of how we believe things. Knowing refers to an intellectual understanding of awareness. So that's a cognitive part of you. The way that you grasp information or facts. For example, you may know that a chair can hold your weight. So I know that if I go sit on that chair. So this is the difference between knowing and believing. But I want to talk about believing this morning. That the love of Christ is, you cannot separate yourself from this love. I know that that chair, if I go sit in that chair will hold my weight. That's something I know. That's not what I want to talk about this morning. I want to talk about believing. I don't want to talk about head knowledge. I want to talk about heart knowledge. You see that there's a difference between the two. Believing goes much deeper and it involves trust and faith and conviction. This is my 13th year. And I can tell you so much. I haven't arrived. I'm 13th year. That's 156 months that I'm still trying to figure this thing out. And what I've realized is that we will never be okay. We will always need Jesus. Amen? When I talk about believing this morning, when I talk about your level of trust when things are not going your way, do you believe that He will never leave you nor forsake you? Will you believe that if you're going through difficult times, that His love is part of you, that you are joined to it? Because if you believe it, then you will experience the love, peace, the joy. You will have faith. You'll be able to endure and suffer long. You'll be able to control yourself. You'll be able to control your response to yourself. If you believe that His love is inseparable from who you are. You're a new creature. Jy's nie meer dieselfde nie. Stop believing that you're the same person. Because you are not. No matter what your family says, no matter what you believe, no matter what is happening to you, no matter how you feel, He has you and He will take you all the way. He's going to take you all the way. Chantal, hy gaan jou die hele pad vat. Maak nie saak hoe jy voel nie. Ek beloof jou, hoe weet ek dit? Want die Bybel sê so. En ek het vasgemaak in my hart dat wat ook al hierso staan in die Bybel, dis so. And even if it turns out not to be so, it made me a better person. But I know that it's true. Because as soon as I started to apply the principles that I read, stuff happened to me. Daar sit 'n testimony van die mooiste vrou wat terug is in my lewe. As soon as I started being committed to what it says here, that was impossible. But we serve a God of the impossible. Hy doen dinge wat jy nie kan doen nie. Hy laat jou toe om weer op te staan. Om weer uit die doodheid op te staan, Jan. Uit die doodheid. Weet nie wie van julle al op 'n vloer gelê het nie en gevoel het of jy doodgaan nie. Was een van julle al daar? Dankie Vader. En dan kom jou familie en vriende in die kamer en sê, "Ooh, ja, like. Dis nou tyd om hospitaal toe te gaan met jou." Naturally. Dan gaan ons hospitaal toe. Dan kom wek die Here jou op. He raises you from the dead. He opens a door. He opens a way. He makes a way where there's no way. Promise keeper. Ne lucky. It is time that we become what he's asking us to become. And he's asking us to become more like him. To be that person, that man, that woman in life, for the person to your left and to your right. I need to be Jesus in your life. You need to be Jesus in my life. Sometimes it's very difficult. The most difficult part of being that person in somebody's life is some days I need to pick up my cross and walk to Golgotha. That means that you'll be beaten. That means that you'll go through stuff. Sometimes it will feel like people are crucifying you. So with this cup in your hand, remember him. Remember what he did for you. Remember what he did for me. Look at the person to your left and to your right. Remember what he did for them. He will do it in your own family. Against all odds. Our reward lies on the other side of the grave. On the other side of the grave. Death doesn't even have a hold on us anymore. The Bible says, death, where's your sting? Death has been defeated. The Bible says so. When we sleep, we will be with him. We will receive a new body. This is the gospel. Okay, so let's continue. Knowing involves understanding, an understanding of theological truth, and recognizing his existence. This is knowing. I know Jesus lives. I know that he died. Even more so, I know that he lives. Believing in God means placing trust in those truths, committing your heart and your life to him. This is believing. Your heart, out of the heart, the issues of life flow. But if I place my heart in a belief that he exists and that his love is inseparable to me, it's a personal thing. Joachim, it's a personal thing. Bew, it's a personal thing. For the Lord, it's a personal thing. It is a personal thing. And he calls you more than a conqueror. Hey, Bew? More than a conqueror. But we will get to that later. So ultimately, belief takes knowledge and turns it into faith-driven action. That's why the book of James says, be doers of the word. Goed om te weet, hierbo, beter om te glo. Want dis my geloofstelsel wat my dryf om sekere dinge te doen of nie te doen nie. It is my belief system that drives me, that motivates me to finish what I've started, to endure difficult times, to endure persecution and suffering. guess what? The life of the believer is not safe. Did you know? The only safety and security we have is that we will enter into, or we have entered into His kingdom. And our eternal fate is safe. Maar terwyl ons aan hierdie kant van die graf is, gaan ons dinge deurgaan, wat okay is. Marcel Berry, dis okay. Lucky, it's fine to go through some stuff. But the way that we go through stuff shows the person next to me what I believe. And that will either draw them into the kingdom of God or push them away. Yeah, amen. Are you ready for good news? Because good news is coming. Sometimes we read the word of God without a true conviction that we are to believe what it says. Sometimes we read it and we read it over and over and over again. And we start to know it. Maar ons glo dit nie. Wanneer daai ding kom in my lewe, that wants to take me off course, that thing that's supposed to teach me and groom me and prune me and prompts me with a decision to either subject that thing under the authority of God or give in to that thing and follow my own way. The day that that thing comes, that will reveal if you believe or not. Remember what I said in the beginning, that emotions and feelings and circumstances comes. And it comes over and over again. But it must never come first. There must be something governing the way that you act, believe, love, talk, dress, feel. The hurt person must go to the other hurt people and say that there's hope for healing. The sick person must go to the other sick people and say that there's healing. The depressed person must go back to the other depressed people and say, there's hope and there's joy. If you still believe that you were saved for yourself and your own family, you are making a mistake. You were saved to bear fruit. Much fruit. There's so much nourishment to be drawn from the person and the work of Jesus. There's so much nourishment that we can apply to our lives in the Word of God. So much to keep us strong during difficult times, to make you pitch up and show up every single day. To also be the same yesterday, today, as far as possible. The life of a believer is not a bipolar life, where you are guided and directed about on how you feel. Today I feel like this, now I must be like this. Tomorrow I feel like this, and this influences my commitment levels. Make a decision. Believe that nothing can separate you from the love of God. Believe that your relationship with God trumps everything in your life. You don't need validation and affirmation from the people around you. You've got the whole Bible full of validation and affirmation. Amen? Nothing can separate you from the love of Christ. Not your past mistakes. Not you feeling guilty about what you've done wrong. Not your failures. Believing that personal or spiritual failures will disqualify you. Your sin, what you do today, the wrong things that you're still entertaining in your life, cannot take His love away from you. Your doubt or unbelief, or your lack of faith, which you can't have. Nobody is devoid of faith. Even if you have faith like a mustard seed, you can say to this mountain, move. Move. We have certain authority in our lives. God-given authority. Do you believe that if the creator of the universe slices off a piece of himself and places it inside of you, the fullness of who he is, that you do not have authority over sickness, over depression? Come on, man. I'm calling you to a higher standard. I'm calling you to believe what the word speaks over your life. You can have the most potential in the world and still choose to be the car god. Not saying that there's something wrong of being a car god, don't get me wrong. But there is fault in it when you have potential to go save thousands, to have... Maria is ook amper daar. Is Maria ook zo rustig? Half mas. The best times of a 40-year-old is when you are sitting on the couch. In your oxen. Nah. Over 40 struggle with this thing. Nou ja, daar is die ding, hier so in jou mid-40s. Yes, my broer. Doukie, is lekker. Ek wil nie eens weet hoe voel oom Basie en Pieter nie. En Koen. The Lord loves us. And His love is, and that love is inseparable. As kies vir julle wat hier voor sit, partykeer spoeg ek. And you need to be okay with that. Paulus het sy sakdoeke en sy het hy gebless en mense het gesond geword. So ek hoop my spoeg as dit op jou val. as ek mis vanmôre vir Jaco, dis hoekom ek hierdie aangesteek het. Mis Jaco, man. He did so good. And then he decided not to do so good anymore. And he decided to go. He ended up to square one. And he died. And we had the honor and the privilege. And the last thing he said to his mom, please come and put my ashes at Ark. Kom en strooi my as. Dit is my laaste wens. That was his last wishes. That was my home. Amen. Nothing can separate you. Not even if you feel unworthy or if you discredit yourself. If you perceive yourself to be flawed, there must be something governing that perception error. Is that nothing can separate you. We know that we are flawed. But the Bible says, blessed are the poor in spirit. Blessed are the person or the people that knows that they are devoid. Because there's this person that wants to come and fill you with himself so that you are not devoid. Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Amen. Other people's opinion cannot separate you from the love of God. Other people's opinion cannot separate you from the love of God. That means that if Allison has an opinion over me, Ricardo is ook amper daar. As kies, die ou moes 40 gewees het, toe hy 6 was, so hy is ook so klein bietjie moeg vanmorgen. What did you guys do last night? Where's the leaders? Owens, hoekom is die ouens aan die slaap? Barry? Yes, moet vir hulle meer koffie gee. Nico, koffie. Koffie, broer. Koffie voor kerk moet ons terugbring. Nothing can separate you from the love of God. Even if you don't feel His presence, the governing authority says that He will never leave you nor forsake you. It means that He's there, no matter if I have a goosebump or not. Sometimes I don't have goosebumps. Sometimes I feel separated from Him. He's there. Sometimes stuff happens to us and we ask and we, Lord, where were you? Wat was jy, Here? He's there. He was there. Nonku, he was there. When you were shipped on your way to Cape Town, he was there. Even your lack of spiritual maturity and knowledge cannot separate you from the love of God. Even if you don't believe that there's a difference between knowing and believing, that cannot separate you from the love of God. Thank the Lord for that. Addiction cannot separate you from the love of God. Your tendency to do the wrong thing over and over again cannot separate you from His love, but you must learn from it. The Bible calls us to be doers of the word. Not only hearers only. So it's good to hear because faith comes by hearing. But believing needs to turn faith into action. Sheldon, ons kan nie weer teruggaan nie. So now we have all this heaped up knowledge of what not to do in life. Vast experience. There's a millennium worth of knowledge inside of this church. Of things not to do. Very, very cool thing. So now we can go out and tell other people, listen here, we need that so do nie. Maybe we should apply to the universities to accredit us with this knowledge, because this is also knowledge. How busy you are during your life, what you do in life, cannot separate you from the love of God. Rejection, or disloyalty, or dysfunction of your friends, your counselees, cannot separate you from the love of God. It means that if I'm inseparable to the love of God, it means that I'm carrying this love of Christ with me the whole time. It means that I have to be Jesus in that situation. It means that I have to draw not from my emotions. That's not where I draw my energy from. I cannot draw my energy, Demi, from how I feel. I need to draw my energy from what I believe. And what I believe needs to be rooted in something permanent that says how I'm supposed to believe and supposed to act. Now, JJ, be rooted and established and built up in the knowledge of Him, in your faith. That's your root system. Below the surface, that's your relationship with Him. So if something comes this way and wants to blow over and question if you can be Jesus in a circumstance, you rely on your root system to dictate how you will be. That will determine the fruit in the situation. If your emotion determines the fruit in a situation, if your emotion, how you feel today, determines how you'll be in that situation, gevaarlik. And my fruit that I give to my neighbor will either draw them or repel them from the kingdom of God. Big responsibility. Are you guys awake? So now we're going into the second reading of our core scriptures. So turn back to the book of Romans. Dankie vir die blaar aan my koeldrank. Maak het moeilik om te drink, jy moet jou lippies klein maak. Want as jy dit groot maak, kan plak op in jou lip vas. Dit is moeilik. Strooikies. Kom, kijk eens hoor. Dank. Als het fauna invloed aan mij. Er was mierkies en yes, ek love die mense in hierdie seisoen in my lewe. I love the people this season in my life. I love the parents and the loved ones and the omas and the opas and the brothers and the sisters and my peers. You know what's the cool thing about this place? We don't see you as subservients. We see you as colleagues. Colleagues in this whole thing. Colleagues in the kingdom. Ons is so. Want ons weet wie ons koning is en hy is op die troon. Ons is nie op die troon nie. Niemand is op die troon behalwe hy nie. Sometimes we place how we feel on the throne. And then we bow down out to how we feel that day. Never take Jesus off the throne. Because he cannot be off the throne. Sometimes your commitment levels will be questioned. Did you know? But your commitment levels must be the same as your original love. Or your original commitment. When I'm in marriage, I am. previous verses in Romans 8. It starts off where Paul describes life in the Spirit. Then it moves on to adoption as children of God. Then it moves over to future glory, despite present suffering. Then it moves over to when the Holy Spirit helps us in our weakness. And then he gets to this thing and he says, what then shall we say about these things? If God is for us, turn to the person to your left and to your right and say, God is for me. Mario said it. Sê weer. Verseker my broer. That defines how I live. That defines how I act. That defines how I feel. That's my belief system. I'm not interested in how I was raised and what my parents spoke over me, what the world spoke over me. I'm leaving that behind. That's my old nature. Later on, Paul talks about the transformation that happens in my knower and my thinker and my believer and my knower or whatever. That this transformation is supposed to happen. Transformation. So I know that vegetables is good. Drink lots of water. And God is for me. Good place to start. Your walk with Jesus. Good place to start. Everything else must go. Vegetables is good. Drink lots of water. And God is for me. Amen. Ek weet dit klink simpel. Maar dit is so eenvoudig. Hoekom wil ek iets anders glo? Why do I want to believe something else than that? That's good things to believe. We know 1 plus 1 is 2. Vegetables is good. Not donuts. Candace. Everything is permissible or lawful. But not everything is good for you. Vegetables good, drink lots of water. God is for you. And who can be against us? So, if the governing authority of the whole universe says that I am for you, ek is vir jou, ek is uitgelewer vir jou, ek is in jou kant, wie gaan teen my wees? Daar is niemand en niks wat teen my kan kom nie. Nie my depressie nie, nie my angs nie, not my fear. Not what the person to my left or to my right or in front or to my back, what they say to me, how they behave towards me. Maak nie saak of ek gemolesteer of verkragt was nie. Maak nie saak hoe ek voel vandag nie. Die Here is vir my. God is for me. Of ek nou kan sien of nou nie kan sien nie. Of ek kan hoor of nie kan hoor nie. Party van ons het al die sintuie, maar ons gebruik hulle nie. Hierdie goeders hier langs ons koppe, partykeer is blompotte, ornamente, soos my ouma altyd gesê het. Ek het nog nooit my ore gebruik in 42 jaar nie, hierdie is die eerste keer. En nou hoor ek die Here praat nie eens deur my ore nie. Hy praat met my hierso. Partykeer praat my hart met my, wat ek lees, what I read. And I can, somewhere he speaks to me, but I can't hear him orally, I can't explain it. Have you ever experienced that? Die Here wat met jou praat. Julle, eers praat ek met 'n vreemde audience, of weet julle waarvan ek praat? Do you know that the spiritual realm we cannot see? Great place to be, if I cannot see. What does the Bible say about this, the spiritual realm? Is that the word of God is a lamp unto my feet and a light. I don't need my eyes. I have them, so it's a benefit. But it's not the defining factor. The defining factor is my believer. Die binneste ding wat vir my sê wat ek doen. That thing must be anchored that God is, if God is for me, who can be against me? Paul is asking, so what shall we say about this thing, about life in Christ, about helping in weakness, about suffering? about the future. What then shall we say about these things? If God is for me, who can be against me? Dis ek love die Here. En ek hou van sy woord. Dis eenvoudig. But sometimes there is two type of stumbling blocks daartoe. In the word of God, you have this moral stumbling block and you have this intellectual stumbling block, a mental stumbling block. What you read, intellectual stumbling block, Lord, I don't understand this. This is wisdom above my knowledge. And you need to read it over and over again. You need to watch a teaching. You need to do research. But then there's moral stumbling blocks. Paul writes moral stumbling blocks. Rejoice in your weakness. Rejoice always, for this is the will of Christ Jesus. That's a moral stumbling block. That goes against what my emotions dictate. So when I suffer, I want to feel I suffer. Ek wil nie suffer nie. Paulus sê, as jy daar kom, so if you're there, rejoice. Prys die Here, lig jou hande. Moral stumbling block. Maak nie sin nie. Die koninkryk van die Here maak nie sin nie, maar dit is oor dat ons nie weet wat aangaan nie. Ons weet nie wat hy weet nie. Amen. Ja. Daar is so baie krag in Driekits Du Plessis se sê ding. Hulle weet nie wat ons weet nie. Ons weet nie wat hy weet nie. Maar ten minste probeer hy vir ons sê. Verse 32. So if God is for me, who can be against me? That's something that you need to fix. Alison, ons moet hom nou vasmaak. Nee, nie. Wanneer my emosies kom, moet ek Here is vir my. Verse 32. God didn't spare his own son. What was most precious to him? His offspring. But gave him. Gave him for who? For us all. How will he not also with him graciously give us all things? Picture of this cheerful giver. God. What was most precious to him? So how must you be with the things that is most precious to you? Which is your time? Give. Freely receive, freely give. Cannot share my heart with all of the people, but I can share my wisdom, can share my time, can share. Sometimes the people will come and they will trap on your heart. You can be so nice and they will step on your heart. That doesn't determine my response. It can never determine my response. Need to be Jesus. I need to be inseparable from this love of Christ. The Bible says so. Nou soos daar, the moral stumbling block. The moral stumbling block from moving from knowing into believing. Ek moet dit glo. The most precious gift that he could give to save you, he gave. You needed a savior. We needed to be saved. We needed to be set free. We needed to be shown a different way to live. We needed to be healed. We needed to be restored. And he shared Jesus with everybody. Here's my son, in whom I'm well pleased. Now kill him. And the people that killed him was us. Was the church that killed Jesus. Difficult. And now you've given your heart and your life to the Lord and you believe that you won't be persecuted. Or that won't go through suffering, Dean. Moeilike tye kom nou. Your testimony will be tested. Your testimony will be tested. Your commitment. When you say that you believe that God will take you all the way and that he's opened the door for you in this season, that was your testimony not too long ago. How can your testimony be seasonal? How can you try to make your own way again in life? You cannot do that. We need to be reliant on this love of Christ that cannot be separated from us. It's the love of God that dictates what we do. And the expression of the love of God is the gospel. The manifestation of His love was the person and the work of Jesus. Amen. Amen. Mm. Yes. That was a nod of approval. Hey, amen. Follow me so. Follow me so. Are you hearing what I'm telling you this morning? Okay, so let's continue. Verse 33, Romans 8. Who shall bring any charge against God's elect? As die Here jou gejustify het, as hy jou vrygespreek het, wie gaan iets teen jou hou? Net die feit dat jou pa nie oor die weg kom met jou nie, of as hy nog nie by daai punt is nie, of as jou ma nog issues met jou het, of as die wêreld issues met jou het, of as die jou eie gedagtes kla jou aan, jou liggaam kla jou aan, who can bring a charge? Wie kan ons veroordeel as die Here ons vrygespreek het? Nie my verlede nie, nie die feit dat heroin my roep nie, of tik my roep nie, of wat Candace vir my dink nie, of sê nie. Nothing can bring a charge against God's elect. And who is God's elect? Church, it's you. Kerk, dis julle wat hier so sit, ons is God se uitverkorenes. You have been entrusted with this message. This gospel, this good news. Bill, die Here het gekom en het jou gered en het hierdie gospel vir jou gegee. Daar's ons my goeie nuus oor jou. En oor hom. Gaan jy hom vertel van my? Is wat hy jou vandag vra. Gaan jy my uitlewe sodat hy kan sien dat jy my dien? If he freely gave his own son, shouldn't you freely give what you have to give? Amen? Hmm. Dit raak moeilik. Dit raak moeilik aan die ander kant van hierdie oop deur. Dis moeilik hierso. So yes, God is 'n God van opportunity en van favor. Maar dit sê nie, jy gaan nie deur die hel gaan om... It's difficult, but it's wonderful. There's these brief moments of happiness in life. But if you take life in the full span of life, Tannie Joey, die lewe is nie funny, ne? Dis nie net funny, fun and games. Oh, damn. Partykeer glo ons, dit is hoe dit veronderstel is om te wees vir die gelowige. Ek het my hart vir die Here gegee. Nou kan ek huis toe gaan. Ek kyk in die spieël, I look in the mirror, I look better, I feel better. Surely I'm healed. Petrus en die ander drie wat saam met hom daai dag was toe Jesus op die beach geloop het en hy het gesê, julle kom volg my, you follow me, and they followed him. They followed him for 3 years. Hulle het nie gekom na 3 maande en gesê, okay, cool, great. Ek gaan terug. Ek's fixed. Thank you. Keep on following, don't give up, don't sell out, don't short circuit, finish, go all the way. And then some. And then come back and fetch people and take them all the way. Go all the way. Don't sell out, guys. Who shall bring any charge against God's elect? People will try, the world will try, sometimes your own thoughts will condemn you. Verse 34. Who is to condemn? Christ Jesus is the one who died. It is important that you know that Jesus died. We love the picture of Jesus on the cross, don't we? It's mooi. Sometimes we wear jewelry with this person on the cross. Even better to know that he lived. And Paul says it, more than that, more than the death. Because the death is one side, but the fact that he was raised is the gospel. Daar's 'n opstanding van die dood. te dank aan Christus Jesus wat vir ons gesterf het. Nou is daar opstanding van die dood. Dis die goeie nuus. That's the good news. Knowing it is half of the thing. Believing it means that you are going all the way. For to me to live is Christ, but to die is gain. Ek is dood vir myself. Ek maak nie besluite meer nie, maar rus is ook daar nou. In die rus van die Here. The picture. Lord, we love you. And now he tells us where this Jesus guy is. So after he died, he was raised. Victory over death. He was raised. And now he's sitting at the right hand of God. Amen? And he's doing what? It also tells us what Jesus is doing there. What does it say? Who indeed is interceding for us. We have this wonderful advocate. Your thoughts, your feelings, the enemy, the world, your family may accuse you, but you have this advocate. That's something you must know. No matter how I feel. No matter what's going on, the good news is that I have an advocate. So die klag kom. So the charge comes. Doesn't matter what way that it comes. Jesus comes and he said, I've dealt with this. I've dealt with this. I saved her. I redeemed him. I parted the Red Sea for him. Verse 35. And now things start getting real. And this is my core scripture. Who will separate us from this love? He came down from heaven, this love. This love came down from heaven. Sandrais Ampada. Ampada. Resoneer. Came down from heaven. Jesus left heaven. He came down. God, okay, God sent him. But he still said, okay. In the Garden of Gethsemane, he said, Lord, please, if you will, take this cup away. But nothing can separate me from your love. I will do this. Let this cup pass. Not my will, your will. He had you and me in mind. He knew the will of the Father. He was doing the will of the Father. So should you and me. There's an urgency. We are living in the end times. He's coming again. I hope I kyk vir jou eie beste en hoe jy kan dinge maak gebeur. Kyk uit vir jou broer en jou suster. As jy stem het, praat. Of sing, soos JJ, ja. As jy 'n talent het, gee hom. Vrylik. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation, difficult times, shall distress when I'm afraid? Persecution, when people do and say things about me, when it's not fair. Shall famine, die moeilike tye. Shall nakedness, times when I feel alone and not worthy. Or danger, when I'm putting myself out there and there's risk, when I'm standing up for the right stuff. Or sword. You see, the day that you gave your heart and your life to the Lord, you are joined with him. And your spirit is joined with Christ in heavenly places. You are now dead and he's alive. He's alive. Verse 36. As it is written, for your sake we are being killed all day long. We are regarded as sheep going to the slaughter. So that's a whole sermon on itself. And that's not my focus. I have a couple of pages on this morning. But that's not... I see that time has caught us. Time catches you. Then there needs to be an urgency. Not to finish life. Like all of us did. We wanted to finish life. That's why we say crystal meth is okay. Because we believe that we are separated from this love of Christ. But now, now that we've heard the truth, something must change in our knower. This thing in our being that dictates how we do things. Dis nie okay om 'n bottel vodka 'n dag uit te drink nie, glad nie. Glad nie okay nie, want ek voel nie lekker nie. Almal is lelik. Ja, miskien, maar die Here sê, ek is by jou. Wat meer soek jy? Whose validation and affirmation are you after? Are you seeking people to recognize you and stick all sorts of labels and badges on you? Ek wil bekend staan as die ou wat hopeloos was. My familie het my afgeskryf. My huisgesin het my afgeskryf. Daar was nie hoop nie. Ek was dood. Dood. Daar is my label en ek wil nie 'n ander label hê nie. Ek dink ek is nog steeds dood. Because sometimes if I look in the mirror, I don't recognize how I act and how I do things anymore. Something changed. Iets het gebeur. Iets het gebeur toe ek die woord van die Here begin apply in my lewe. Something happened to me. Kan dit nie verduidelik nie. Joachim, kan dit nie verduidelik nie. Ek weet nie wat nie. Ek is nie dieselfde mens as wat ek was nie. Ek doen dit nie meer dieselfde nie. Partykeer kom hy nou en dan uit. Nee, hulle sin, partykeer kom hy. Ja. En dan voel hy so sleg, skaam. Ek wil terugtree en ek wil myself isolate. Dis juist wanneer jy moet uitkom en sê, nothing can separate me from the love of God. Broer, sister, ek is hier vir jou. Ek is nie hier vir myself nie. Vrou, dogter, ek is hier vir jou. My man, ek is hier vir jou. My ma, ek is hier vir jou. Ek kyk nie vir my eie beswil meer nie, ma, pa, broer. Die goeie nuus is ek is dood. And there's no need for a ceremony or a memorial. Let's read. Victory. There's this contrast that is happening. So we are being sent like sheep to the slaughter. Awesome. As it is written, for your sake we are being, and that is in the book of Psalms somewhere, 40s. All day long we are regarded as sheep being slaughtered. Now there's this contrast that Paul is trying to get across, that we have victory in suffering. Moral stumbling block. I don't understand that victory in my suffering. Suffering is not where you are now. This is consequences, by the way. Suffering is doing the right thing. And stuff happens to you. In that moment, when things are seeming unfair, when I don't agree with circumstances, I have victory because nothing can separate me from the love of God. If He's for me, who can be against me? And in that situation, I need to be Him. Difficult. Moral stumbling block. Verstaan jy hoe nie? Kan dit nie doen nie. Dankie Here vir genade. Thank God for grace. Allowing me. So that's unmerited favor. So that's the one well-known definition of grace. But let me tell you my definition of grace. It's His influence on my heart to do the thing that I cannot do. Nee Marcel? As ons kan buite toe gaan en ons kan vir mama sê, jou mama's nie meer nie. Ek wil dit nie doen nie. Ek kan dit nie doen nie. Maar ek doen dit. Doen die onmoontlike. Ons glo nog steeds oor die profetiese woord oor daai girl. Ons weet wie sy kan wees. Verse 37. Now in all these things we are more than conquerors. Not by our own accord, not because we are so oulik, but through Him who loved us. More than conquerors, why? Because He loves me. And He conquered first. That makes me more than a conqueror. That's how I go through life. This is something I must fix here. More than a conqueror. More than a conqueror. Easy to believe it the day in church. It's easy to sit here now and believe. Yes, awesome boodskap. Maar wag vir daai dag en hy kom. As hierdie ding getoets gaan word. And your testimony will be tested. What you hear today will be tested. Why? Hmm. Jy kan sê jy's 'n stukkie goud, maar ons moet dit eers bewys. Jy gaan getoets word. Your perseverance, your faith, and your endurance will be tested. If you say that you are a child of God, you will be tested. To reveal the root system. The parts that the people don't see. When you are alone, when you have freedom for the first time. Ek sê ek het my kinders lief, maar die oomblik toe ek vryheid kry, toe hardloop ek terug na die duiwel toe. Dan het ek nie my kinders lief nie. Moeilik. True. Now I need to learn what love is. And that happens below the surface. My root system. Let's continue. More than conquerors. Why? Because he loves me. Verse 38, for I am sure that neither death nor life, while you are alive, can separate you from his love. Not angels, the most powerful beings in the universe, can separate you from his love. Or rulers, people in authority, people that have dominion. No things present. Doesn't matter what's going on in your life right now. Nothing can separate you from the love of Christ. Nothing can separate you from the love and the finished work that is in him. And he's calling you to be the same in this world. He's calling you to be that light, that hope, that beacon, that person, that savior, that redeemer, that points people back to him. So ons hoef nie die Bybel te ken nie, ons hoef nie papiere te hê nie. We just need to tell people, listen, I have so good news. You that is depressed, you that is hopeless, you that want to commit suicide, you that is stuck in addiction, you that loves the bottle. Good news. Nothing can separate you from the love of God. Change your life. Repent. And live inside of this kingdom. No powers. Verse 39. No height. You will go to great heights in this life. But you must be rooted and grounded and established in his love. That cannot separate you. It must keep you humble. When you soar like an eagle, you must stay humble. Because pride comes before a fall. If you believe that you are bigger than life, and if the Lord has blessed you with an anointing, in a salving, om hoog te vlieg, nothing can separate you from his love. Not even the height or the depth. How low you go in life. Or anything else in creation. You see that there's not this war going on between God and the devil, Jock Price. Daar's nie 'n oorlog aan die gang nie. You have God and then you have creation. Klaar gepraat. Daar's nie die oorlog nie. Die oorlog is net hier so tussen die knower en die believer. Daar's hoe die oorlog. In wat jy glo. The war is what you believe. Now you have this book that is telling you what to believe. Amen. And then Paul ends the chapter in Romans 8 and he says, nor anything else in creation will be able to separate you, to detach you, to disjoin you from the love of God in the absolute display of his love, his son, sending his son in Christ Jesus, our governing authority, our Lord. Amen. I hope that you all got something from this morning. Let's pray. Koppies. Aha, ek het twee. Kom ons vat ons shots. Kom ons doen die geheime handskud. We must stop being stuck in religion and tradition. We must start being the next chapter, start doing this. Being Jesus in the current generation. Vrouens, julle moet koptoeke dra. Julle hoef nie, dis die goeie nuus. sê saam met my, vat jou broodjie. This is the symbol of Christ taking all the lashes that he took, all the ridicule that he took, all the beating that he took. This is the symbol. Liesel is smelling the body of Christ. Why are you smelling the body? It's weird. Maar ons love jou weird. Ons is ook weird. Die liggaam van die Here. Moet nooit dink jy gaan hom nou eet en dan gaan jy siek word nie. Die liggaam van Christus was gebreek. It was broken for you and for me. So that's the dying part. The dying part. And the red part, the fluid part, is that he washed away. Made you clean. Queenies. Good news. Not the same person. No matter who's accusing me. Sometimes it's my own thoughts and my own belief system. But remember, let go of your belief system, Jan. Vegetables are good. Drink lots of water. And nothing can separate me from the love of Christ. That's my new belief system. That's how I live my life. That's why I treat you like I treat you. Sometimes. Other times I don't treat you like that. Forgive me. Forgive me. Repeat after me. Father, we thank you for everything that you've done. For your marvelous plan in sending your only son to die for me. Lord, I receive his broken body for me. You can partake of the bread. Voel julle anders? Gaan nie oor gevoelens nie. Onthou die Here, en ek wil nie klein maak wat hy gedoen het nie, maar onthou hom, remember him. Although it happened long ago, doesn't matter. He's alive forevermore. My Jesus is alive forevermore. Kyk daar, daai ouetjie glo Jesus. Ek wil ook so wees. There's so much wisdom to be gained from children. I learn from my kids. And they're supposed to learn from me. Or so we think. But the Bible says, unless you become like these little ones, you will be in no means. Okay. Let's remember the blood that he shed. Repeat after me. Father, I thank you for your son. Thank you for the shedding of blood, Lord Jesus. That is washing me clean every single day. You can partake. Let's pray. Father, we thank you for your love and your grace. Lord Jesus, we thank you for your obedience and your teaching. Holy Spirit, we thank you for your counsel and your wisdom. Thank you for allowing us to be human while we figure this salvation thing out. Because it's not easy. Thank you that you see the beginning from the end. Thank you that we can trust in you. Thank you that we can believe in you. Thank you that we can believe in the plans, the prophetic plans and the promises that you have over our lives. Thank you that we can anchor our decision making and our choices and the way that we respond and react and the way that we feel by this governing authority that resides in your person and the fact that you love us and the fact that you are alive. Lord, we ask that you help our unbelief. And I'm praying specifically for the people that is feeling depressed and broken and unsure and fearful this morning, Lord, that you will come and just reassure them that nothing can separate them from your love. Almal wat so klein bietjie angstig vanmôre is, wat hartseer is, wat hard probeer, wat moet oorbegin. Here, ek bid vir hulle vanmôre, Vader. Bid vir die kerk en die liggaam, Here. Lord, I'm praying for the whole body and all believers around the world, Lord. Teach us the importance of staying in unity and in step with your spirit. Lord, I'm praying for our country that you will raise up people in authority that will lead and guide this country to new heights never seen before, that you will make a way in this desert, that you will do a new thing. And even in this center, Lord, I pray that you raise up, and I'm praising you for raising up leadership that is able to take the reins in their families and their communities. People that will stand up for the right thing, not fall for the wrong thing anymore. There's so much potential in this building, Lord. Take us and make of us something. Expand our territory. Bless our next step. Let our next step be in the name of the Lord and expand your kingdom. Lord, thank you that you heal us. We bless your holy name. And we ask that you prepare us for the week to come in the mighty name of Jesus. And everybody that loves the Lord says amen. Amen. Thank you. This is more.